The topic is from core to a blessing. Living life positively with HIV. It's because I myself am HIV positive. Okay, how it all began? The flashback to year 2004 when I met a person whom I fell in love with, whom I thought he would be a good husband. Of course, he was a very gentleman-like, and everything was going on so great until I became pregnant on the year 2004. And it was such a happy news for me to be a mother. So I was like, when I did that home detection kit where you, that pregnancy card, which shows the two lines, full of happiness, I went to my husband saying, look, you are going to be a father. And the only thing he told me is, let's go to the hospital. I said, I don't need to go to the hospital because I'm perfectly fine, all right. But still, he insisted that let us go to the hospital. Okay, I thought he's going to do some medical test on me or maybe some health checkup. So I went. And then what happened there was something totally different. He forcefully made me to abort my first child. And like that, not just the first one, the second, the third time also I became pregnant 3 times in the gap of 1 year. 3 times I had been forcefully taken to the hospital for abortion. Abortion is not my choice. It was his choice because he did not want to be a family man. And second, I didn't know what to do that time because I thought that I had to live with a person, so I have to listen to him if I have to make my marriage work. And yes, my talk is very bold, so please, there is nothing to be embarrassed of because it will also help you in learning something. After I did my first abortion, I thought of using a precaution because I came to know that he did not want to be a father, so I used the oral contraceptive pill, but it was not working on me because I used to get a lot of severe side effects like vomiting, headaches, underbody pain, and so on. So I used a vaginal contraceptive pill, and the failure rate of vaginal pill is very high. It requires 5 to 10, it requires 10 to 15 minutes of waiting period time. And you cannot just tell a man, just wait, let the medicine take effect, and then we will do what you want. So, like this way, 3 times when I became pregnant, 3 times I was forced to go to the hospital, which was not my choice anyway. On the 4th time, when I again became pregnant, the medical report came out saying I'm HIV positive. Now, the question is, how I became HIV positive? It was going in my mind, and I look at my husband, and I was looking at him with a doubt in my mind. So he said, no, it is not me. I'm going to do the test and I will prove it to you that it was not me. So, okay, he did the test. His test came out HIV negative. So I was like, how is it really possible that if he is negative, how come my test shows HIV positive? Maybe there is some mistake in the lab test report or something else. So I did my own research. I went to doctor, then I went to the lot of caregivers, and I wanted to find the answer to my question. And then I went to that abortion clinic too. And I later found out that the doctor himself was HIV positive, and he had, during the time of Doing that abortion process on me, he had cut his finger and he had inserted the wounded finger inside my body. So that is how the blood which had dripped inside my system, it multiplied, and that is the reason why I became HIV positive. And now, when the going got tough, the tough got going means I faced a lot of stigma, I faced a lot of discrimination, and then my family abandoned me. My friends also abandoned me, yeah. The one thing I came to know when... Okay, so you were never my friend for life. So I know who is my friend, who is not. Okay, then my journey. I was hearing disabled at the age of 3. I was told by my parents that I had fell down from the motorbike when my father was driving. And in that process, there was some inside head injury which deteriorated my hearing. Along with it, I have a speech problem. But the doctor turned to disagree. They said that maybe it was more because of physical abuse than because of accident. As a physical abuse, how come? He said that you may be slapped hard or hit hard. Oh, yes. I agree to that because I have a stepmother, so I tend to believe the doctor. Anyway, since I have a stepmother and my father who only cared for me, I never felt love. So that means I come from a broken home and a broken family. And just because I did not get the love, care, attention at home, I ran away from home at the age of 18 and built up my own life. Married on 2004, gave birth to child on 2008. When I was undergoing the fourth abortion process, that time when I was detected HIV positive, the doctor gave me an option whether you like to abort the baby or you wanted to carry on. I selected to give the birth to a child. He was born HIV negative, thankfully. And I also suffer from marital rape. Marital rape is like when I do not want to do it, when he is so eager to do it, then it is term and rape, because anything that is forced upon your body is a rape which is not recognized by Indian government. And domestic violence is because he wanted a divorce. And I was not ready for the divorce because I had a child. And postpartum depression is because it is after pregnancy. So I was divorced on 2008, again not my child, and with no alimony, not even a child visit. Anyway, after that, I was like what I wanted to do, because I had suicidal depression and all this, but life was so beautiful, only people make it so complicated, so I wanted to know what I had to do, because some way I had to live. So I tried to make friends, I googled, I found a website that give a support to HIV positive. So I joined the club and the community of HIV people. Then I came across a Facebook group, International Place for the People Living with HIV, which is like a whole people go join into one group, one Facebook site, and that when they speak out their feelings and everything, so it made me feel like there are many other people who are suffering, so why should I alone suffer? And that gave me a strength to move on. Then I started with blogging about my experience, and with that blogging I got noticed. And then this blogging is for the USA website, and I was like a fourth best blogger in the world. And then because of this, I was made the community advisor board for US organization. Then there was also a Pakistan organization. And so on. So I am currently holding 4 to 5 positions. And my role model, it is Mother Teresa, and She had taught me what unconditional love is all about. And Princess Diana, who had taught me what about the selfless giving. Okay, and this is my motto actually, that you never know how strong you are until being strong is the only choice you have. That means suicide is never an option. Thank you. And I'm going to tell you my contribution with my favorite music in the background. Please play. Okay, so this is all about not to judge people, just love them. And that is what I mean. Thank you so much.